Hi, I'm Jim Dill. I'm the Pest Management Specialist with the University of Maine Cooperative Extension. And we've been trapping for spotted wing Drosophila. And the first thing we want to start to talk to about today is the trap, what to do, and then what to look for in the fruit. So first, let's look at a trap. Let's take the top off this trap. This has been out here for about a week. And as you take the top off the trap with the bait, you can zero in here. And there are many, probably right now, I can see about 25 small flies floating on the top of this trap. And you can look down and you can see the spots on the wing of the male. Again, that's the male spotted wing Drosophila. The females have a tendency to either float, or when they sink, their ovipositor, which is what they use for their to lay eggs with, actually becomes overted, and you can see that. So it's easy to tell the males and the females in here, because the females do not have the spot on the wing. So you've got your traps out and you've started finding spotted wing Drosophila in your trap. So the concern now becomes is what's happening to the fruit. We have been finding here in Maine this year, which is 2012, we found maggots or flies so far in raspberries, blackberries, blueberries, elderberry, grapes, chokecherry, and peaches. Now traditionally, the fruit flies that we have would come to the overripe fruit, and with their ovipositor, which is what they lay their eggs with, it's not serrated, doesn't have that little saw-like on it, so it has to be very, very soft fruit for them to lay an egg in. But this one, now with this serrated ovipositor, can actually lay the eggs in fruit like this, or even like this. So once you get fruit like this attacked, it doesn't take long before it starts to shrivel up. Let's see what's happening here with the fruit. We'll pull some off, take a look at it. So this is what's happening, and you see when you pull that fruit off too, it almost looks bubbly in there, like almost like there was a detergent in there. That's because the fruit has been all started to be eaten by the maggots, and then once it's been eaten by the maggots, it gets real juicy. And in this particular berry, just looking here, as I move this apart with a pen, I can probably see at least a half a dozen or a dozen maggots right in this area. Part of the problem is with this pest, when you go out and you pick your fruit, it looks great on the vine or on the bush, and within a matter of maybe 24 hours with raspberries or 2 or 3 days with blueberries, they just start to turn to liquid. And you can actually see some maggots crawling on the fruit, but even worse, you can see where from this box where it's actually started to liquefy and the box has soaked it all up, but on the outside of the box, you've got all these maggots crawling around. These are about a week old on the blueberries. Now the raspberries, these were nice fine looking raspberries yesterday. And if you look down onto the berries have just starting to turn to mush. And again, you've got maggots crawling, coming from the berries. And some of these berries have just completely, as I say, turned to a mush. The problem becomes within a minimum, in this time of year, in the summer, a minimum of 14 days, and it may be even as quick as 10 days, the fly can go from egg to adult. So it's a real fast critter. So that's going to give us real problems with trying to manage this particular pest in whether it be a backyard situation or a commercial situation.